Record. Okay. So there is a question about the lab. It says in Turkish, raporla ilgili bir şey sormak istiyorum. Bir 5 sütun için KY'yi hesaplayıp ortalamalarını aldık. Sapmayı da büyükten küçüğe çıkarıp ikiye bölerek yazdık. Bu yaptığımız doğru olur mu? Sapma soruyor, sapma soruyor mu? Şeyde, raporda. Yani K hesabında K'nın şeyini soruyor mu? Sapmasını veya hatasını. Diğer bir soru Seda soru sorabilir miyim diyor. Evet sorabilirsin. Laboratuvarla alakalı. In the second question of the second part of the report, we couldn't understand. How can comment on the parameters and verify the field strength? Well, this means that I think you haven't carefully watched the video introduction, and this will be clear. You will understand as soon as you make the plot of the electric field versus x cube or x or y, you will, you know, make two plots and you will find a parameter. Please do that and read the expression for the dipole electric field. So it is like k times q times d divided by x cube and or y cube. There is this expression. Obviously, on top of x cube or y cube, there is this expression. One KQD or the other one is 2KQD. So obviously that collection is going to be that multiplication KQD or 2KQD is going to be your parameter. Since you have not done the plot yet, this is not clear in your mind, okay? Once you do the plotting, the curve fitting, you will understand what this parameter means, okay? And also it is explained in the video, in the first introduction. I hope that way you can understand. Okay? Evet arkadaşlar lütfen yani şimdi laboratuvarla alakalı size zaman ayırdığım zaman o sorularınızı o süre içerisinde kullanın. Bir gün önceden de bir akşam önceden de hazırlık yapın. Yani yarın laboratuvar videonuz olacak. Ben size duyurdum. Ve burada ne soracağınızı hazırlayın. Şimdi ben problem çözerken şey olmasın. Oradan oraya daldan dala atlamayalım. Okay, so the next question is about again, you know, let me read it about the flux. There is a point charge, a part charge of 10 to minus 6 coulomb, microcoulomb, sorry, is located inside a sphere. And what is the flux through the sphere? Okay, so let's first draw a sphere. Well, it doesn't look like a sphere, but you know, I will try my best anyway. Okay, so suppose this is a sphere and let me draw a, you know, three-dimensional representation. This is the equatorial region and this is the representing the other, the equatorial line on the other side of the sphere. And let's think that this is the center. So, you know, if this is the center anyway, this sphere has some, of course, radius. It has a radius, let's say R, right? And well, the problem is not asking particularly that this charge is located at the center, but it just says it is, you know, somewhere inside the sphere. But suppose, for the time being, suppose that the charge is just right located at the center of the sphere. So you just put this charge right over here. So there is nothing else. You have this sphere, which has the radius r, and inside at the center you have this charge. Would you have a flux through the surface of the sphere in that case? Well, obviously, if there is nothing else in this picture, what you have, that if you put a charge right at the center, this point charge obviously will produce the electric field in space, electric field around it in space. So what is the electric field around this charge? You know this. The point charge is producing electric fields, if this is a positive charge, radially outward in every direction, right? So this is the electric field lines that this charge is producing. It is going to be outward, because if the charge is positive, well, if the charge would be negative, the only difference with this picture is that the direction of the arrows are going to be reversed. But since we have a positive charge, they are radially out. So what you see is that, well, these are the line, and these lines obviously are crossing the surface of the sphere. So because of the definition of the electric flux, if electric field lines are crossing a surface, a particular surface, then it's going to produce a non-zero flux. Yeah. Because the electric flux is just defined at the number of lines that are crossing a surface. So obviously there are this many lines. Well, you can draw as many lines as you want to represent. Well, of course, per unit charge, you can just say that, for example, if this is a 1 coulomb, then I just represent 10 lines for 1 coulomb charge. In that case, if that is your choice, if there is going to be two coulomb charge over here, this will produce 20 lines, because you just made the convention that 1 coulomb is producing 10 lines, and 2 coulomb is going to be producing 20 lines, etc. You know, but we will see that the number of lines it has a specific value, which is set by the Gausses itself. And I will discuss this later. Anyway, so, you know, just the representation. It depends on the magnitude of the charge. The number of lines that crossing the surface depends on the magnitude of charge linearly. If you double the charge, then the number of lines will double crossing the surface, okay? But the bad thing about this is that this surface is curved, not a planar surface. How are you going to define the area vector? Because if you just, you know, concentrate on a specific point, like just this point. Think about this point, right on this, you are on the surface of the sphere, right? On the surface of the sphere, thinking about this point. What is the area vector? Well, obviously the area vector is going to be perpendicular. It's going to look like this. But if you go somewhere else, like this point, the area vector is going to be pointing like in this direction. And this area vector and this area vector, obviously, they are not in the same direction. So the direction of the area vector is changing through a curved surface. If you have a curved surface, not a planar surface, the area vector direction is not unique. And it depends on the location you are on the surface. For example, think about this point. This point will have the area vector, which is in this direction. Obviously, this and this are area vectors, but they are completely in opposite directions. Okay, so it might be confusing for you to choose the area vector for a curved surface, but there is a way for that, especially if your surface has some certain symmetry. If it is a certain symmetry, then obviously this area vector, for example, for a sphere, is going to be in such a direction at a particular location that if you you know, continue the line on the area vector, this line will obviously cross the center of the sphere, right? Wherever you draw your area vector, if you make the continuation of the line of the area vector, this line will always cross, okay? It will always cross the center, through the center of the sphere. And well, that's okay. But what about, you know, the magnitude of the area vector? Well, the magnitude of the area vector, since the area vector